YouTube, this is Ray again, another video review. This review was requested by Dan. Dan's one of my subscribers and he is a big fan of Transformers, Jurassic Park and yeah, dinosaurs. He also has a site, check it out, it's gptoys.com. And he also has a great forum, so check that out. Anyway, the review here is about Masterpiece Optimus Prime, MP1 and MP4 by Takara. Masterpiece Prime here. The cap actually comes from the MP1 set and the trail from MP4. There's not a lot of difference in it. I was just too lazy to get the Prime out of this box because I already took it out of that box. Basically the same figure with a couple minor things that were changed. Very minor things. You see it here compared with G1 Optimus Prime. This was an original Optimus Prime from 21 years ago when I got it. I got my A certificate with swimming and my mom got this for me. Very, very cool. It has yellowed and I'm currently missing some items like its gun and the roller. I do have them somewhere, but yeah, I don't know where exactly. And here is world's smallest Optimus Prime. Very, very cool. Let me just put these to the side for now. And take a closer look at this one. The trailer. I just put him on the stands. You pull this out. And you press this down. On both sides. Like so. And it will stand. Let's take a look at the cap. As you can see, it's a very, very nicely done and authentic G1 Optimus Prime. Looks very, very cartoon accurate. It has a very, very nice metallic finish. It's also very heavy because it's mostly made of metal. Very, very nice chrome here. Also on the wheels, the smokestacks, fuel tanks, you name it. The biggest difference with the Hasbro version is that this one has a very nice red. It's kind of reddish orange on the Hasbro versions. Also the chrome, instead of this very nice chrome, it's more of a silver. You can't really see it in pictures, but in person it just doesn't shine the same way. Also, yeah, as already mentioned, the small smokestacks. And this one has a very nice sculpted on Autobot symbol here. And it doesn't have one on the other side. I'm pretty sure the Hasbro versions have it on both sides. Also, they released two so far. Same as the MP1 with the 20th anniversary. It had battle damage. And the second one didn't have the battle damage. So if you are going after a Hasbro version, which are cheaper than the Takara versions, I'd definitely get the second one with without the battle damage. What's cool about the Hasbro version though is that with the Takara versions, they had this crazy idea to make his handgun gray with baby blue. Yeah, we should be lucky it's not baby pink, but it still sucks. The Hasbro version actually has an all black gun, which is far better, far nicer. Rubber tires and work suspension on the back wheels. Now let's take a look at the trailer. As you can see, it has the stance. It's very, very cartoon accurate. Let's just compare it to the original. Looks very much identical. The biggest change here is that instead of just with the ramp here, actually has two doors, open like this, and then the ramp, and just put it on camera for you. It fits one alternator just perfectly. And you can also see the scale is very nice between the alternator and Prime, so you can can easily put them together and display. Just put them aside for now. I'll get into the interiors of Thread later on, and I'll just compare it to the others. Closed up for now. What's also nice on the trailer is that he has very nice lights here, clear plastic. He doesn't have a license plate, which is kind of a shame. Wish it had the license plate. Would have been cool if it said Cybertron or Prime on there. It just would have been a very nice touch. It has a very nice color as well. It looks metal, but unfortunately it is not. Now for the transformation. All prime like this. Separate the legs, like so. Press the fuel tank. Pull out the leg, same on the other side. Now move this in. Go to the foot. On the bottom, this piece, make sure it's down. Now take this piece, move it up on both sides, rotate foot and press this in. Also on this side, turn it around, move it forward and move it in like so. Now take these pieces, this side and this side, and flip them forward like this. Go to the bottom, move this down, open these up. What's kind of cool is that you can see a chair in there, and the armrests are actually Prime's ears. Collapse the seat like so. Take these panels, move them forward like that. Take this piece, unpack it, keep it like that for now. Go to the sides, take the arms out like that, also on this side. Okay, like that. Move them out, bring this down, take out his head, move it up, close it back up. What we do now is you move this up, you turn this around, and this could get in the way, but okay, fold it like this, turn this around like so, move this to the side like so, turn it and keep moving it to the side so it is centered like that, and press it into the chest like so. Put it down. What you do now is move the arms out of the way, keep this open, take this piece, turn it forward and move it up and click it into the chest like so. Also on this side, move it up, click it into the chest. What we do now is we take the legs, make sure the back panels are out of the way, turn it around and collapse it like this, click this in, close these up like so. Go to the back, click these together, and last but not least, go to the panels on the bottom here, pull them out, move it forward, click it shut. There is Prime in his robot mode. Please head over to part 2, and there I will discuss the robot mode and to show you the trails and compare it to the other versions of Prime. So stay tuned and see you in part 2.